Yes, students. Next, we are going to start our chapter number 3, that is human reproduction. As we know that the mode of the reproduction in the humans is sexual reproduction, right? Sexual reproduction, we know very well that in which the two parents are involved, one is the male and the another one is female. Male is producing the gamete, that is sperm, and the female is producing the gamete, that is known as ovum or egg, right? When there is a fusion of these two, male and the female gamete, what will happen? That will happen So seminiferous tubules are the point where the sperms are going to be formed, and then the sperms will be transferred to the rete testae. After the rete testae, they will go to the vessa efferentia. They will go to the vessa efferentia, right? After the vessa efferentia, there is a quiet tube-like structure, right? We have a tube-like structure, right? I am making a simple diagram so that you are able to understand what is the route of the sperm, right? How the sperms are moving from the testes to the outside, or you can say the vessa efferens, right? So firstly, the sperms are produced inside the seminiferous tubules, which are present inside the every testicular lobule, right? Then it is forming a kind of
the sperms, right? That male germ cells are nothing but the
takes place and the development of embryo will be going to take place, right? So first of all, here just see the diagram. There is a pair of ovaries. I have made only one side, but this will be like that. So the same will be here, right? So there is a pair of ovary. You can see on each side there is a pair of ovary, which is a primary sex organ, and the function of the ovary is to produce a gamete as well as to produce a female sex hormone, that is estrogen and progesterone. Next, there is a fimbriae, right? Fimbriae are which are going to just take up the gametes from the ovaries, right? And then there are three regions of the fallopian tubes, right? Fallopian tube is there on either side of the ovary, right? This is also a fallopian tube, this is also a fallopian tube. So it's a pair of the fallopian tubes present in the female body. And that includes the three parts. What are that three parts? One is the infundibulum, right? The part which is direct in contact with the fimbriae is known as infundibulum. Then is the ampulla region, which is highly swollen region, ampulla, and then is the isthmus region. Now, the question is that the fertilization is going to take place in the fallopian tube. Now, where in the fallopian tube? That occurs in the ampullary isthmus region. So, the site of the fertilization is very specific, and that takes the ampullary isthmic region of the female reproductive tract. So when the sperms are going to inject from here, the sperms will go here because of the motility. Sperms are having a mobile nature. They can move in one direction, or they are having that motility because of its tail, right? So sperms are going to move here, and activity here, and the fertilization is going to take place here. So this is the site where the of the female fallopian tubes, right? Next, this is the fallopian tubes, right? There are three regions of the fallopian tube. Next, this is the uterus, and this is also known as the womb, where the development of the embryo takes place, right? The zygote is formed here. Now, the division of the zygote will take place, right? We all are the human beings. We started our life as a single cell, right? I am a single cell, you are a single cell, because we all have started our life from a single zygote. Now this zygote is going to multiply, and one zygote will multiply, it will form two cells, two to four cells, four to 16 cells, right? So when these cells will multiply, and finally it will form the blastocyst form. When it will be in the form of blastocyst, it will just implant itself to the inner wall of the uterus. This inner wall of the uterus is known as endometrium, right? This is the site where the blastocyst is nothing but the mass of the zygote in the multiplied form, right? It is a 32 approximately cells. When it is multiplied, that will become equal to 32 cells. Now it is ready to implant itself to this endometrium. That takes almost 4 to 5 days after the fertilization. So implantation will be taking place in the endometrium wall, right? Endometrium is the inner wall of the uterus. This is the place where the implantation will take place. Now, after the implantation, we can say that the woman is pregnant. And when the woman is pregnant, the cycle, that is the menstrual cycle, that is not going to take place, because that cycle is associated with this. Now there is no formation of the this egg will take place, and then no menstrual cycle will take place once the woman gets the implantation. different tissues are there, and here you can see the lactiferous glands are there, nipple is there, areola is there, right? And this is known as the ampulla, right? So this is the structure of the mammary glands, which will become active only after the birth of a baby, right? That is followed the parturition, the lactation will be there, and the mammary glands are going to perform the function in that, and they are also known as, mammary glands are also known as the secondary sex organs, because they are producing the milk and they will help in just feeding the young one after the birth of the baby, right? Next we are going to discuss about the oogenesis. As we have discussed in the spermatogenesis, that is the production of the sperm, same in case of oogenesis. Oogenesis means the production of the ovum. But in this case, the process is somewhat like different. In the human male, what happens after the age of puberty, right? After the age of puberty, only then the spermatogonia are going to perform its function. But in case of the female body, during the embryonic stage only, the all process is going to take place. Suppose a woman is pregnant, right? So in her womb, if that fetus is a female child, right now from that beginning in the embryonic stage, the process is going to take place. The ovaries are going to perform its function. So what happened? In the first month, this is now that we are talking about the embryonic, right? The girl has not taken birth yet, it is under the mother's womb, right? So during the first month, how many follicles are there? 1700 primary follicles are there. This is the first month of the embryonic development. Now this will undergo the more cell division and more multiplication and will result into the 600,000 primary follicles, right? This is month. This is first month of the embryonic development, right? The girl has not taken birth yet. And then second month, multiplication will be there, multiplied, right? The primary follicles are getting multiplied and result into the 600,000 primary follicles, right? Which will further go and the multiplication till the fifth month of the embryonic development. The number of the primary follicle is approximately equal to 7 million, right? Now, when the girl has taken birth, right, at that time, how many follicles are there? 2 million follicles. Why it is reduced? Because of shrinkage, right? Then the shrinkage will take place, right? After the shrinkage, now the number of follicles that remains in the ovaries is 2 million primary follicles. Now this spermatogonia body, right? What we have done during the structure of the ovary, that the egg release always in the form of secondary oocyte, right? The egg which is released from the ovary during the process of ovulation is always in the form of secondary oocyte. So this is the place where the meiosis 1 has taken place. Meiosis 2 is going to take place only when the sperm is injected, right? Or when the sperm is entered into the female body and the fertilization is going to take place. Only then the meiosis 2 is going to complete itself. Otherwise, the meiosis 2 is not going to take place. Meiosis 2 in case of oogenesis takes place only in case of sperm entry when it is going to form the zygote. With the sperm, right? So this is all.